Yes, brother. Can you pose a question?
Dr. Mahadevan, practicing medical practitioner. Day before yesterday, I attended Mr. Abdul Rahim Green's lecture. There was a question posed to him by a medical student. She asked about paradise. Those who practice Islam go to paradise and the rest of the people go to the hell. Is it the answer given by Mr. Abdul Rahim Green was not convincing. Can you please explain? Thank you.
Brother, the question somebody asked, Brother Abdul Rahim Green, that those who practice Islam will go to paradise, those who don't practice Islam will go to hell. The answer wasn't convincing. I wasn't there. I'm sure Brother Abdul Rahim Green may have given a very convincing reply. Maybe you didn't understand certain of his points. I know him, he's a very good speaker, mashallah. But regarding the reply that will Muslim go to Jannah and non-Muslim go to hell, brother, the requirement to go to Jannah is given in Surah Al-Asr, chapter number 103, verse number 1-3. It says, "Wal as inna insana fi khusr illa allazina amanu wa amilu salihati wa tawasaw bil haqq wa tawasaw bis sabr." By the token of time, man is very in a state of loss, except those who have faith, those who have righteous deed, those who exhort people to truth, that is to dawah, and those who exhort people to patience and perseverance. The requirement for any human being to go to Jannah is four things: iman, faith, what I discussed, pillars of iman, righteous deed, exhorting people to truth, and exhorting people to patience and perseverance. If any one of these four is missing, under normal circumstances, you shall not go to Jannah. Only by calling yourself Abdullah, Muhammad, Sultan, Zakir will not take you to Jannah. Just by saying, "I am a Muslim," you don't go to Jannah. I said in my talk, Allah says in Surah Ankabut, chapter 29, verse number 2, just by saying you believe, just by saying I am a mu'min, I am a Muslim, do you think you'll go to Jannah? Allah will surely test you. So just by saying I am a Muslim, you will not go to Jannah. A person who practices Islam, Islam comes from the root word salam, which means peace. It also means submitting a will to God. A person who submits his will to God is called a Muslim. So a person who follows the religion or submitting his will to Almighty God is a Muslim. So anyone who submits his will to Almighty God, whatever his name may be, he will go to Jannah. So criteria to go to Jannah is having iman. In all the pillars I mentioned, Almighty God is there, you have messengers about the hereafter, about his books, etc. Doing righteous deed and submitting a will to Almighty God. If you submit a will to Almighty God, in Arabic it is called as religion of Islam. But it doesn't mean that if you live in Pakistan or live in Saudi Arabia, you go to Jannah. No. All the people in Saudi Arabia, all in Pakistan, Allah alone knows whether they go to Jannah or not. The person who go to paradise, brother, is one who obeys the commandment of Almighty God. The person who obeys the commandment of Almighty God, and I discussed many in my talk, if you obey these commandments of Almighty God, just by name, calling yourself Muslim or Muhammad or Abdullah, that will not take you to Jannah. It is not compulsory to change your name. The name, Green, is not a Muslim name. So that doesn't mean you won't go to Jannah. We prayed to him that may the brother, inshallah, no, he has reverted. He was a Christian. So the name will not take you to Jannah, your deeds will take you. Believing, your deeds, exhorting people to truth, and exhorting people to patience and perseverance. If your deeds are right, if your iman is right, and you exhort people to truth and patience and perseverance, inshallah, any human being, he shall go to Jannah. Hope that answers the question.
May we have the next question from brother here. Brother, at that mic, can we have the question from you?
Yes, good evening. My name is Sri Ram. I am a Hindu. Without practicing Islam, do you mean to say it is difficult by practicing Christianity or by Hinduism to go to attain the paradise after death?
Well, that's a very good question. Without practicing Islam, can you practice Christianity and Hinduism? Can you go to paradise or you cannot go to paradise? Brother, as I said, the Quran says in Surah Imran, chapter 3, verse number 19, "Inna dina indallahi al-Islam." The only religion acceptable to Almighty God is submitting will to Almighty God. If you read Christianity, the word Christianity is not there in the whole Bible. Like how Hinduism is not there in the Hindu scripture, the word Christianity doesn't exist. It's not there in the Bible. The word Christian was used first time in the book of Acts by the people to describe the followers of Jesus Christ, peace be upon him. It was a nickname by the people given of Antioch in the book of Acts, if you read. Christian. The word Christianity is not there in the Bible. So Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, preached nothing but Islam. Therefore, he's going to come in the second coming to testify. There's nothing like Christianity. Abraham, peace be upon him, Quran says in Surah Imran, chapter 3, verse 67, he was not a Jew or a Christian, he was a Muslim. Abraham, peace be upon him, taught Islam. Moses, peace be upon him, taught Islam. Again, Islam. Don't think Islam is okay, fine, I have to have a Muslim name, I have to live in Arab country, I have to have a Zakir name, Abdul. Islam means submitting a will to Almighty God. If you submit a will to Almighty God and a Muslim, Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, said, it's mentioned in the Gospel of John, chapter number 5, verse number 30, I can of my own self do nothing. As I hear, I judge, and my judgment is just, for I seek not my will, but the will of Almighty God. Anyone who says that I follow not my will, the will of Almighty God, he's a Muslim. So Jesus Christ, peace be upon the Muslim, he preached Islam. I've given the talk on similarities between Islam and Christianity. And I've proved that even in Christianity, they say believe in one God, don't believe in Trinity, don't make images of Almighty God, God is not begotten. All from the Bible. From the Bible has proved how to offer Salah. From the Bible, about Zakat, about Hajj, should not have alcohol, about modesty from the Bible. So even Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, he did not come to preach Christianity, he came to preach Islam. And Almighty God is the same God for all the human beings. He has only given one religion, no other religion. All these are corrupted form of the original religion. Like how the brother said, Sufism. Even that's a corrupted form of Islam. It is not Islam at all. What we have to follow is true Islam, the Quran and the Sahih Hadith. And all the messengers, they taught only Islam. So if you follow Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, by going to the scriptures, Jesus Christ never said worship me. He never claimed divinity. In fact, there's not a single unequivocal statement in the complete Bible where Jesus Christ, peace be upon himself, says that he's God or where he says worship me. But the Christian says you cannot enter paradise until you believe Jesus Christ died for your sin. He was Almighty God. There's not a single unequivocal statement in the complete Bible where Jesus Christ, peace be upon himself, says that he's God or where he says worship me. If any Christian can show me any statement in the Bible where Jesus Christ, peace be upon himself, says that I am God or where he says worship me, I'm ready to accept Christianity today. In fact, Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, said, it's mentioned in the Gospel of John, chapter number 14, verse number 28, he said, my Father is greater than I. Gospel of John, chapter number 10, verse number 29, my Father is greater than all. Gospel of Matthew, chapter number 12, verse number 28, I with the Spirit of God, I cast out devil. Gospel of Luke, chapter number 11, verse number 20, I with the finger of God cast out devil. Gospel of John, chapter number 5, verse number 30, I can of my own self do nothing. As I hear, I judge, and my judgment is just. For I seek not my will, but the will of my Father. He submitted his will to Almighty God, you are the Muslim. It's clearly mentioned in the book of Acts, chapter number 2, verse number 22. He said, ye men of Israel, listen to this. Jesus of Nazareth, a man approved of God amongst you, by wonders and miracles which God did by him, and you are witness to it. A man approved of God amongst you, by wonders and miracles which God did by him, and you are witness to it. So if you say Christian means a person who follows the teachings of Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, then I say we Muslims are more Christian than the Christians themselves. The Bible says don't have pork. Bible says the woman should cover the head. It's mentioned in the 1 Corinthians. 1 Corinthians chapter number 11, verse number 5 to 7. The woman that does not cover her head should be shaved off. So brother, all the messengers of Almighty God, they taught nothing but Islam. Islam is submitting a will to Almighty God. So if you submit a will to Almighty God, you'll go to paradise. If you don't submit, you will not go. Hope that answers the question.
We have time for one last question.